A little burrito told me, whoop, that you want to get started in the food truck business. So you requested a quote from a builder. And when you got it, woo! That's what you did. Because I know that's what I did. I'm like, there's got to be a better way. And let me show you that there is. I'm Frank Baltierrez on the DIY series, How to Build Your Food Truck. Let me show you the other way. So once I received my quote from a builder a few years ago, I was like, man, this is crazy. I didn't have any money to build it. So being in the construction business, being an electrician, I was like, it can't be that much harder than like running can lights in the attic, putting bending pipe, pulling wire, and knowing enough construction. I was like, I guess I can probably build it myself. So I came on YouTube University and I saw a few videos that really helped me out. And that's when I decided to help you guys out again. In case you guys were searching on Google and YouTube, you're probably like, man, I found this guy. Who is he? Let me see what he can show me. So on all the previous videos to this, I've taken empty trailers, two of them, and I have built them into food trucks or food trailers, whatever you want to call them. It's the same concept, being a food truck or food trailer. A truck might take a little bit of more work because you have the engine underneath a truck, like a tool truck. And a trailer is a little bit more simple because you really don't have a motor besides the axle that runs underneath the trailer. So I put these videos together and hopefully they are of good use to you. Any questions that you have, please drop them in the comments. Every video is kind of strategic on how I built it, starting from the electrical, the hood, the window, the plumbing right back here, the water tanks, the water heater, the drain lines, all that fun stuff that comes with building your food truck or food trailer. And to be honest, it is not too difficult. It does take a little bit of sweat equity or hard labor, but I believe you can do it. And with the guidance of these videos and you asking questions on the videos, I believe you can do it yourself as well. And at the end of this video, I do have a one-time announcement that I want to do on almost like a DIY project that I have. Not this one, but something that you guys might be interested in. So stay tuned towards the end of this video. I'll put that up there, right there for you as well. Again, Frank Baltierrez on how to build your food truck. And today we're going to be talking about a little bit of the plumbing, some of the gas lines that go right over there that feed the equipment, because we're wrapping up a lot of details on this trailer being a 7x16 trailer. And it has a 7-foot hood. I think so. 7 or 6 foot. It's a 7-foot hood. That's what it is. So that's what this is right here. So let's get started on this. And let me show you how I have built this food truck. To finalize this plumbing here, there's one more thing we have to do. And that's adding the drain lines or the drain pipes off of here. These are 1.5 inches. You have one on the gray water tank and one on the fresh water tank. And what we're going to do here, so we can exit it outside the truck or the trailer, we're going to come this way and then 90 right out. And then we're going to put a gate valve outside. I'm going to show you how that looks and how I do it. And I'm able to hook up a hose to it, which is very easy to be able to take out the water. That's the one you're going to use mostly, is that wastewater tank right there. And that's how you take out the water at your commissary. So let me show you how I do that and the parts that I use. You're going to need those little street elbows, little shorty ones, and a gate valve that I'll show you right now. Using a hole saw, to me, is one of the cleanest ways that you can get a nice circular hole so you can put that 1.5 inch PVC down for the drains. Here I am showing you how I cut the PVC. There are other ways to cut it. You can also use a Sawzall. I like my Multitool because you can use it for a lot of different other things besides just cutting PVC. We do the same thing again with the hole saw and the other tank. That way you do two holes, one for the fresh and one for the gray. These are the parts that you're gonna need to be able to, you see that one, that's the 90 that goes down into the trailer, and then that's gonna exit out and then it's gonna come out this way, which is going to be, if you guys can see, right around there. That's where they're gonna be. Obviously this is a before video, so you guys will see the after product right now. But these are the two pieces that you'll need. One is this gate valve by Valterra. Very, very hard to find. I did not find that on Amazon. They used to carry it on Amazon, and for some reason they stopped carrying it. So I do not know where you can find it, to be honest. But just Google that, Valterra 1.5 inch gate valve. But make sure that it has threads on this side. They do have it where you can buy it where the pipe goes in, the 1.5 inch PVC. And the same thing over here, but I like this one that's threaded because then you can connect this, a gray water 90 degree connector. And then that just
goes right in there. You guys can see there. It connects, and then you can use a 3/4 inch hose, which is what I told you that you can use to dump out your water. That way you can direct the water exactly where you want it. So 1.5 to 3/4 gray water drain connector. Drains gray water with gray water flushing hose. So there you go. That's exactly what I use to be able to finish up these water tanks right here. My little tricks that I have here, your drain connector, and then your gate valve right there, made by Valterra. They're both actually made by Valterra. I just noticed that. Look at that. Fancy. So let me show you the finished product that I have here. We have our PVC running down from the tanks, as you can see. And then you get a little 90. And then that's where that gate valve goes right there. And then with that little 3/4 nozzle. That's basically, I try to kind of make it really surface. On my trailer, I kind of did a little bit different because it was my first one that I ever did. But I try to make it really snug up to the stud. So I can put a strap here if I wanted to, so it can be a little bit more sturdy. But look how tight that is. This thing ain't going nowhere. But you can put one there just for safety purposes. Is it needed? Not really. If you do a real good job and you make it real nice and tight up to the stud right here, I would call it the floor joist of the trailer. But that's how that looks. Just wanted to give you a quick peek of what I did here. A 90 down and then straight into the gate valve, and then the little nozzle right there, which lets all the water out. Easy peasy. In case you guys want a better visual on here, I use these unions right there. This is called the union, 3/4 inch union, a little nipple. And then I come down here and then I use this 90. This one is a fixed up and then it 90s out like an elbow. And then it has this, it has a T, and then another one of these. I don't know what's it called. Let me look at the name real quick. Give me 2 seconds. That right there is called a street 90, a 90 degree street 90. That's what that's called right there. So 3/4 inch street 90. I have 2 of them. Because it's so much easier just to be able to squeeze that right in there. So that's what I'm going to be connecting together with the blue monster that I have. I'm going to make this all real nice and neat. And then put the valves and the flex lines that I have on there. Home Flex from Home Depot is where I buy it. This blue monster for me is a lifesaver. You can also use the tape, like a gas tape that you can put around the threads. I don't like it because sometimes I put it the reverse and then you thread it and then it comes off. So to me, the Blue Monster, phenomenal product. Laying everything out here so I can finish up this little contraption that I made. In a few seconds, you're gonna see the layout of everything so you can take a screenshot and that way you can buy all the parts necessary. With the assistance of that clamp and a lot of hard labor and work, I was able to make my little contraption here. So this one is going to get a flexible hose that's gonna go to my griddle. This one's going to go to my char broiler, and then this one I'll feed over to the burner. You guys can see here I have all 3 of them set. 1, 2, 3. This is a 36 inch, this is a 24 inch, and then this is a 12 inch, and those get all fed right there. And then this bottom one is going to go all the way behind the water tanks, and it's going to feed the water heater that you see right over there. So it's going to be right around there. And then this is the main one. And it has a little shut off as well, a ball valve. And that's going to, that goes over to the main propane lines that come from the front. That's just like a little safety thing that I have. And obviously that's your fire suppression system that I've been talking about. But that's how that looks at the end. If you guys want to take a screenshot of that, that's something that I use and I love the setup here. Right now what I'm working on is something called an LP conversion, or liquid propane conversion from natural gas. A lot of this equipment, if you don't buy it already to be liquid propane, which almost they're like double the price, they do give you a conversion kit, which are just little different orifices, as you can see right here. So right here, you just swap these out that are right there. Those are for natural gas. They have one on this side, one on this side, and then this side had 3 of them. I'm not gonna show you how to do it, just because I don't wanna be responsible for showing you and then something happens and be like, hey, he's the one that did it. Because this is at your own risk, or you can hire somebody to come swap it out for you as they recommend on the instructions. But I'm just letting you know that if you buy one, for example, like this one, CPG, Cooking Performance Group, from Webster Rants, griddle, charbroiler, or burner, you have to convert it to LP if you want to use it in your food truck, because there is no natural gas in a food truck. It's only propane.
So it's a little bit different. It's still a flammable gas, both of them. Just one is different than the other. In what way, I really don't know. Obviously, one's for commercial restaurants and one's for commercial food trucks. But there you go. That's what I'm working on. A conversion from LP, from natural gas to LP. Are you guys ready for the big announcement? Well, here it is. I present to you this red monster. Can we call it Big Red? I do like that name. It's a Cargo Mate Blazer, 7x16 trailer, exactly just like my trailer. The only thing that makes this one a little bit cooler, which sometimes makes me want to keep Big Red here, is that from here to the from the top, it's 7 feet tall. So the interior of this one is 7 feet tall inside, mine is 6'6". Those 6 inches make a huge difference. Let me show you the inside so you guys can get like a complete picture of how it looks. You have all the regular studs up top. It comes at factory installed with plywood. I know you guys ask me all the time, what kind of plywood do you use? Well, I do not use any because it already comes with plywood. I think this is 3/8 plywood. There's a front of it right there. That's where typically like all the sinks go. If you guys can visualize it, that's exactly how all my trailers are. There is no difference. I would not buy something that I would not use myself. I just honestly do not have the time to be able to do it. So I want to give the opportunity to somebody that wants a complete kit. It has a hood. It has a 7-foot hood right there. It has a little canopy, that the exhaust canopy. It has the window ledge. I also have the concession window already ordered, so it's here. So it's not like you have to order it and it's red. It's pretty cool, actually. I have all the FRP walls, and I also have one piece of stainless steel that you would need to put right here for the backing on the equipment. So I already have that as well. As I said, this is a complete kit. All you really have to do is put the work in, and you're ready to rock and roll. I'll give you the outlets, the switches, the breaker panel, the food trays, the shelves. Everything you need is right here. So if you have any interest, drop it in the comments, or email us to rollingburritosfoodtruck@gmail.com. Let me show you real quick how this looks. This is the front. Nothing special about it. It's just the typical front of a trailer. This is where you put the propane tanks right there, and then you can put the generator tray right there where it'll power everything up. Right here is where your generator plug would go. So there you go. That's exactly kind of, like I said, literally it's a twin of mine. So you're able to just rock and roll, copy exactly what I have and use it for here. But that's the front of the trailer, and I already showed you the sides.